What's up, Snappers? Yeah, so basically over the weekend, I did some very strange social experiments. Not proud of what I did so far. I'm not sponsored by any company, but huge shout out to Face App for making me look like a woman. Truly regrettable times here. Okay, so yeah, so let's kick into detail on what actually went on. So before that, let me start with some disclaimers. So yes, before we start anything, before I come across as offensive or insensitive, I do want to set some like disclaimers out there so you guys can understand where I'm coming from. So let me just get out of bed and, you know, wash my face, have something to eat, because I just woke up. So yeah, let's do it.
Many unbearable hours later.
What's up, Steppers? I'm back from washing my face, and yes, so disclaimer wise, yes, firstly, if you're easily offended, please go to your nearest YouTube channel to find like mukbangs or what, you know, that would be so much better than watching my crappy videos anyway. So yeah, and also this was just a, you know, experiment. And knowing how boys feel on, you know, Tinder. Yeah, I mean, I reduced the risk so that they don't experience what I did in the past. So yes, yeah, I mean, this is my 2 cents, and if you don't agree with it, please kindly, you know, continue to live on. Alright, let's start. Let's just start with the background story. I use Face App. Shout out to Face App for making me look like an awesome human being. And then make myself turn into a woman. Basically a face with a man body, over broad shoulders for, you know, everything, hands that give away, that is definitely for myself. Gosh, that is terrifying. Alright. Yeah, so then after that, I basically went to Tinder and catfish many people, which I'm not proud of. So I'm sorry guys, if you have been catfished by Jax, this is real. The ex, if Jax talk about the exes that she has, that's just my story, so I'm sorry. Alright, let's start. So the first point I like to prove is that I always believe being on Tinder as a girl is easier than being a boy there. I mean, the numbers don't lie. And you know, there's a top button with a, you know, golden button with the number of people that likes you. I mean, that's not indicative of matches, but people who like you, they don't pop out on the screen. They may or may not pop out on the screen, but I mean, this is a good indication of how many people swipe right on you. And so, it's a shocking truth, I got way more, the number there was way larger than my 2 years of effort combined. So shout out to Female Jax, he did a very good job. I wanted this experiment to last for 5 days, but after one night and one morning, I couldn't take it any longer. I felt so bad for the people. I mean, me being a guy myself, I've been catfished by many of these before, and yeah, actually this was just to prove a point. And yes, point proven, and you are more likely to get swipe rights, mutual swipe rights, because for me doing this social experiment, I didn't care about who I was looking at. I was just, you know, just seeing, just generally speaking, how do people look, what do people, I mean, like, not say how do people look, but what do people look in when they swipe on Tinder. But, you know, conclusiveness wise, brain fart. Okay, so basically my conclusion is they don't, they also just randomly swipe right. Oh, also partly maybe because my picture was so heavily well done. Thanks to Face App, I actually look like a kawaii anime girl. So checkmate all them out there. And yes, yeah, it was fun. And it was hard to prove my innocence. And yes, I could. It was exhausting. My every line has to be, my every reply has to be very curated to make me sound like how normal, like how girls would text back, like, if they feel that you are a creep. Probably not reply back anymore. Or like, I don't know. I mean, like, or like at times I just give one word answers. Oh look, so as I'm speaking, many more matches are coming and I will not be accepting any of them, and I'll close my account right now after this channel has been broadcasted. And yes, so on to my second point. I mean, my second point is not really a point, it's more of a slight confession. Like, I understand, like, some people, especially some guys, might be guilty. They tend to, like, you know, read into the bio and then I create a stupid pun out of it. Guys, I learned this the hard way. It's not cool. Nothing good comes up from that shit. So yeah, and so basically, yeah, I mean, I received yeah, a message saying, I'm not gonna ask you for your B and your V, but I will want to celebrate your birthday and Valentine's with you. I'm like, what? No, oh my god. Okay, I mean, that was a good try, but I tried it on somebody and it didn't work. So, point proven, it doesn't work. Just get out of the app. Go find friends. Like, serious, you'll be better off finding friends than actually wasting your 3 years of non-experience on that app. So yes, that is my second point. And on to my last point. Okay, so my third point is that oh crap. Yeah, okay, so my third point is that nobody takes Tinder seriously. Right. So basically, like my what mentioned in the past, the first point, they really swipe left for fun. I mean, some of them, they would really want to find their partner, which is unfortunate if I catfish them. So alright, but there are others that were just looking for a quick benefit out of it. I've seen one very disgusting bio that basically sexualize women in the first two lines. Not recommending you do that. No, kids, do not do that. Never ever do that, guys. Never. Oh my god, that will be the worst cardinal sin you have ever committed in your life. So never ever do this. And yeah, so the whole time I was thinking, I mean, I do not have perfect information, but I was thinking based on past experience how how do people how do people really react in such a situation? Like, I mean, if I was a girl and I reacted to this, I mean, like, I see this thing happen to me, like this guy with this kind of like bio come up to me and it won't be nice. It won't be nice. It doesn't work. Yeah, and also it's sometimes really hard to be on the receiving end of 99 notifications, especially when you have meetings and stuff, and then like, you have a new match. The funny part is, being a catfish experiment make this even funnier. Alright, so back to my point, never take Tinder seriously. So in conclusion, if you really want to find somebody, I suggest you try other apps like OkCupid or CNB, or get alive, like what I'm not doing right now, and get out and find some friends, a mix of them, maybe like a few guys, a few girls, find some one of them that you like or some stuff, and you know, try to get to know her and basically show that you are a decent human being and not like some of those people out there. So yeah, that concludes it for my crappiest video ever. Yeah, so I do not condone any like form of social experiment that is in fact just a catfish exercise. So yep. And this originally stemmed from my friend commenting that he's having a dry spell on Tinder, and I wanted to prove it because I experienced that before and to show him that he's not alone. To the woman ladies out there, no, we are not trying hard. I'm just trying to prove a point to my friend. And yeah, if, honestly, if you don't like any of these points or you agree with any of them, please do let me know. I'm trying very hard to be very sensitive, but if I do come across as not nice, please. Okay, you can tell me, DM me, but please do not put me up on internet and blame me. I have enough of that, honestly. Well, would just like to add on that there were too many factors that affected why it was true lah, even though like we get the general trend, but still. Yeah, I mean, so there could be variations where we just didn't try hard enough or we just suck. So yes, that concludes it for my video, and it's Jack signing off as an actual man. Jolly suit.